Hi, yes, we are teachers, lifelong learners. I, Professor Pratibha, I welcome you back in our YouTube channel. Yes, and today I am here with new video on the new course. Yes, that is B.Ed. course 202, Knowledge and Curriculum and Language Across the Curriculum. Today also we are having practice of some MCQs. But if you are new on the channel, please don't forget to subscribe our channel. If you like the video, please like it and share it with your friends. Thank you. So let's start the practice. Yes, today we are going to cover different topics, and the topics are language, meaning home language and school language, standard language, foreign language, Bullock report with reference to the concept of language across the curriculum, and multilingualism concept and types. Question number one is, home language is otherwise called as. So you all know that there are different names for the home languages, and you have to find out which is the other name for the home language. So there are four options, and the options are A1, mother language, 2, arterial language, 3, first language, and 4, all of the above. Okay, so if we see the mother language, it is also called as home language, it is also called as mother language. It is a first language of a person, and it is also called as arterial language. So here we are going to lock option number 4, that is the correct one. So let me lock the option. Question number 2, a person who has more than one native language is regarded as. And the options are bilingual, multilingual, the third is both, and the fourth is none of the above. Please read the question very carefully. A person who has more than one native language is regarded as. So here we are counting that more than one native language. So it can be bilingual, it can be multilingual. So here we are going to lock option number 3, that is both, that is the correct option. Question number 3. See, always we are using the word at L1 and L2. So it is related to language 1 and language 2. Okay. So contemporary linguistic and educator community use the term L1 to refer to a dash dash, and the term L2 to refer to a second language or a foreign language that is being studied. Actually, if we see, I have given the half answer in the question only, because here the term L2 to refer to a second language or a foreign language. So you can think that there can be more than one name for the L1. So of course, L1, that is the first language. Okay, and like this means here the second language and the other name, that is the foreign language. So here for L1 also, the first language, that can be a one name. Okay, and there can be a other name also. So whatever options given here, you have to first you have to read the options, and the options are first or native language, the second is only first language, third is native language, and fourth one is none of the above. But if we see L1, it is first language or native language. So here we are going to lock option number 1 as a correct option. Question number 4. A home language is the language or the variety of language that is most commonly spoken by the members of a family for everyday interactions at home. Okay, this question is basically, it is related to the home languages, the language spoken by the all members of the family for the everyday interactions. And the options are, what it called as, so options are the family language, the language of the home, third, both, and fourth is none of the above. And the correct option is, see, it is called as the family language, it is also called as the language of the home. So here we are going to select option number 3, that is the correct one, both. This is question number 5. Which statement is not true regarding to characteristics of first language acquisition? So here For answering this question, you should know different characteristics of first language acquisition. How you are acquiring the first language and what are the characteristics of the acquisition of first language. And the options are given here. It is in the statement form, and the options are: one, it is an instinct; two, it is very rapid; three, it require instruction; and four, it is very complete. Before finding out the correct option, we should know what exactly it is. So let's start with the first option. It is an instinct. Okay, so instinct means what? So this is nothing but it is triggered by the birth. Okay, and what is meaning of it is very rapid? If you compare the learning of this first language, means acquisition of the first language, with the second language. Okay, so time duration it is required for the acquisition, it is comparatively it is very less. So that's the reason we can say that it is very rapid. Okay, the third is it is very complete. See, it is very complete means what? The quality of first language acquisition is far better than that of the second language. Okay. And because of this, we cannot forget our native language, means we cannot forget our first language. Okay, that's why it is called as it is a very complete language, or the language acquisition it is very complete. Okay, so this is the meaning of the option number 1, 2, and 4. Then what about the instruction? It require instruction. Okay, for example, suppose the native language, or we can say the mother tongue or the first language, it is Hindi language, or it can be a Marathi language. Okay, so to learn this particular language, or to learn this first language, mother is insisting her child that beta ye bolo ye sikho. So it's not like that, so it can be learned without instruction. So we are going to log this option number 3 as a correct one, because this is not true regarding the characteristics of first language acquisition. जिसके लिए इंस्ट्रक्शन देने की जरूरत नहीं, बच्चे अपने आप, जो फर्स्ट लैंग्वेज है, जो मदर टंग है, वो अपने आप सीख जाते हैं. उसके लिए उनको कोई भी इंस्ट्रक्शन देने की जरूरत नहीं है. सो हियर आई एम गोइंग टू लॉग दिस ऑप्शन नंबर 3 एज अ करेक्ट ऑप्शन. Question number 6, the first language of child is a part of the dash dash identity. Okay, please read all the options very carefully. And the options are: option number 1, personal; option number 2, social; option number 3, cultural; and option number 4, all of the above. Okay, see, the first language of a child is a part of course, it is a personal identity. For example, suppose I belong to Marathi family, so my first language is Marathi, so it's my identity, I'm Marathi. Okay, so, and the social is related to the society, the particular group of people, they are following the same rituals. Okay, they are having the same language, they are having the same first language like this. So again you can say, and for communicating they are using the same language, so it can be a social identity. And the third is cultural identity. Of course, for example, particular person is belong to particular, what you can say, suppose the Marwadi language. Okay, so here that particular student is belong to that Marwadi society, or you can say the Marwadi family, he belong to that particular Marwadi family. So that can be a cultural identity also, right? So here we are going to log option number 4, that is all of the above. The first language of a child is a part of the personal, social, and third is cultural. So here we are going to log option number 4 as a correct option. Yes, this is question number 7. There is no reason why a female adult human being be called a woman in English, aurat in Urdu, zain in Persian, and feminine in French. The choice of a word selected to mean a particular thing or idea is purely. If we see this question, it is related to the characteristics of languages, and whatever options are given here, they are nothing but the characteristics of languages. So this example is related to which characteristics of languages we have to find it out. So, but before selecting correct option, we should know different characteristics. Whatever options are given here, we should know different characteristics of the languages. So we start with the first option, systematic. Yes, language is a systematic. But if we see language, it is a symbolic. Okay, and yet all the symbols, they are arranged in a particular system. That's the reason it is called as a systematic. Okay, so whatever application means, whatever example is given here, it is not related to the option number one. I'm going to merge option number three and four together because the creativity and productivity, right? So I'm going to merge both the options, that is option number three and four together. Language has creativity and productivity. Means what? Kya hai iska meaning? Means जो भी स्ट्रक्चरल इलिमेंट है ह्यूमन लैंग्वेजेस की, उसको कंबाइन करके न्यू अटरेंसेस प्रोड्यूस किए जाते हैं, ठीक है? और ये जो न्यू प्रोडक्शन है, वो आज तक किसी ने सुना भी नहीं रहता, किसी ने उसको बोला भी नहीं रहता, ठीक है? लेकिन जब भी वो दूसरे के साथ कम्युनिकेट करते हैं, तो वो अगर ये न्यू वर्ड्स जो भी है, वो अंडरस्टैंडिंग में डिफिकल्टी नहीं आती. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ लैंग्वेज. बट अगेन वी कैन से दैट दिस ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री एंड फोर इज वॉट एवर एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन हियर, इट इज नॉट रिलेटेड टू ऑप्शन नंबर थ्री एंड फोर. सो वी हैव टू थिंक अबाउट द वॉट एवर लेफ्ट ऑप्शन विथ अस अबाउट दैट. सो आर्बिट्रेरी मीन्स वॉट? ओके, सो वॉट इज मीनिंग ऑफ आर्बिट्रेरी? डू यू नो वॉट इज मीनिंग ऑफ आर्बिट्रेरी? ओके, सो आर्बिट्रेरी मीन्स देर इज नो इनहेरेंट रिलेशन बिटवीन द वर्ड्स ऑफ अ लैंग्वेज एंड देयर मीनिंग और द आइडियाज कन्वेड बाय देम. प्लीज रिमेम्बर, देर इज नो इनहेरेंट रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द वर्ड्स ऑफ अ लैंग्वेज एंड देयर मीनिंग और आइडियाज कन्वेड बाय देम. एंड वॉट एवर एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन हियर, इट इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, दैट इज लैंग्वेज इज आर्बिट्रेरी. Okay, so here I'm going to log option number two as a correct option. Okay, let's move ahead. Question number eight, a dash dash language is a language variety used by a group of people in their public discourse. Okay, so options are standard, foreign, cultural, and none of the above. If we see whenever a particular language, okay, language used by a group of people in their public discourse, so there is a particular name for the language, and that nothing but the standard language. Okay, so a standard language is a language variety used by a group of people in their public. Okay, I think next question, it is also related to this. Yes, question number nine, a standard language can be pluricentric, it can be monocentric, both or none of the above. Yes, standard language, as we saw before, that standard language is a language variety used by a, you can see the variety, language variety used by a group of people in their public. So it can be monocentric, it can be pluricentric. Okay, so here we are going to lock option number three as the correct one, that is both. Yes, question number 10. A language for life, better known as, in your syllabus, there is one. I think easily you can give answer of this question. It is very, very easy because whatever options are given here, you can easily eliminate options. Okay, so whatever options are given here, see, there is a Skinner theory, is there, Chomsky theory is there. There is no report related to Skinner and Chomsky. So automatically I'm going to eliminate option number two and three. Yes, now out of two means option number one and four, I have to select one. And see, in your syllabus of 202, there is one report, that is Bullock report. It is given. Okay, Bullock report, it is related to knowledge across the curriculum. And the name of that Bullock report, it is a language for life. Okay, so here we are going to log option number one, that is the correct one, a language for life, better known as Bullock report. Question number 11. This question, it is also related to the Bullock report, and the question is, Bullock report was UK government report published in dash dash by an independent committee chaired by Alan Bullock, and the options are 1865, 1965, 1975, 1875. Okay, and the correct option is 1975, option number 3. Bullock report was UK government report published in 1975 by an independent committee chaired by Alan Bullock. So see, there may be chances of asking different questions based on same question. They maybe they will ask you about the Bullock report was dash dash report published in 1975, the same question. Even they will ask you about the chaired by whom. Okay, so Bullock report was UK government report published in 1975 by an independent committee chaired by Alan Bullock. Okay, so there are chances to ask many questions based on the same statement. So please remember this. One more question based on the Bullock report, and you might be confused. You might be confused between the 2 years, that is 1975 and 1972. So let's see what is there in the question. So question number 12 is: a Bullock report is a British report on teaching English as a mother tongue, presented by Committee of Inquiry set up by the Secretary of State for Education and Science, Margaret Thatcher in dash dash. Okay, so see, the report was published in 1975, but report was presented in 1972. So here I'm going to log option number 2 as a correct option, that is 1972. See, again, there are chances to ask different questions based on the same. They will ask you about, okay. So Bullock report is a British report on, so you have to fill in the blank, that is teaching English as a mother tongue. So report is based on what? There may be chances to ask question based on this also. Presented by whom? So presented by Committee of Inquiry, set up by Committee of Inquiry. So that can be another question. Even they will ask you by set up by the Secretary of. So this can be the third question. And they will ask you the name of the Margaret Thatcher. Okay. So on the same question, there are chances to ask 3 to 4 more questions. Okay. So please remember this. I think you have a clear idea about the when that particular report is presented. So it is presented by Committee of Inquiry set up by the Secretary of State for Education and Science, Margaret Thatcher, in 1972. And I'm just switching to previous question. And the same report is published. See, the presented is different and published it is different. Presented in 1972 and it is published in 1975. So please remember both the things. Okay, let's move towards the next question. See, basically I like this topic very much because I'm very much familiar and daily I'm experiencing the same thing. So let's see the question is, the question number 13, which statement is not true about multilingualism? And the options are, option number 1, multilingualism refers to an individual speaker who uses two or more languages, or to a community of a speaker where the use of more than one language is common. Okay. So you simply can see that this is the definition of multilingualism. So we cannot say that this is not related or not regarding multilingualism. So this is related to, this statement is true related to multilingualism. Then the second option is multilingualism, it is not an abnormality. Of course, it is not an abnormality. जो multilingualism use करते हैं या फिर एक से ज़्यादा languages use करते हैं वो use करना यानी abnormality नहीं है. Okay. So again, this statement is true related to multilingualism. Let's move towards the next statement, that is multilingualism is the act of using polyglottism or using multiple language. See, there is another word for the multilingualism, that is nothing but the polyglottism. Okay, that the meaning of this, that is multilingualism, is using more than one language, that is nothing but the multiple language. More than one means multiple language. So if we see, all the three options are true regarding the multilingualism. So here we are going to log option number 4. I think now your concept of multilingualism, it is clear. So here we are going to log option number 4, that is correct option, none of the above. Now I'm expecting correct answer from your side because just now we have discussed about the multilingualism concept. Yes, dash dash person is one who can communicate in more than one language, be it actively or passively. Okay, and the options are multilingual, second is polyglot, third is both, and fourth is none of the above. And I am sure that your clear idea about what is multilingualism, it is also called as polyglotism. Okay, it is there in the previous. See, here you can see that is polyglotism. So here the person is one who can communicate in more than one language, be it actively or passively. So multilingual person, polyglot person, both. So if we are saying that multilingualism, that is nothing but the polyglotism. So multilingual, that is nothing but the polyglot. So there is another name for multilingual, that is polyglot. So here you can use both the thing, that is multilingual person or the polyglot person. Okay, so here I'm going to log option number three as correct option. Question number 15. Out of the following, which is odd man out, related to need of multilingualism today? See, it is very nice and interesting question. We have to find out the odd man out and what your options are given there. The options are, we have to find out the option which is not related to need of multilingualism today, because today's age is the technical or the science age, and we are saying that the 21st century. Okay, so in this 21st century there is a need of multilingualism. Of course this is very true, and we have to find out the odd man out related to the need of multilingualism today. Let's see the options. First option is it increases vocabulary and effectiveness of speech. Second is job mobility. Third is shorten employment opportunities, and fourth is abroad study. Okay, so now you know that is which is the first language, which is the native language, which is the standard language, which is the secondary language. Okay, and now we know that the English, it is an international language. Okay, suppose the person, he is knowing more than one language, he is using more than one language, that person is nothing but the multilingualistic person, right? So there is a need of multilingualism today. And if we see whatever statements are given below, we have to find out the odd man out. So of course it increases the vocabulary and effectiveness of speech. Because of multilingualism, it is easy to switch the job, so there is a job mobility, of course. And if the person is know the foreign languages, okay, so that person can go to the abroad for the further study. So this statement means the abroad study, it is also a need, it is related to the need of multilingualism. Okay, only we have left with one option, that is option number three, shorten employment opportunities. This is totally incorrect related to the need of multilingualism today. Because the person who is having, who is using multi languages, we can say, so that person is getting more employment opportunities. So this statement, this short term, this is exactly incorrect related to the multilingualism. Okay, so now I'm going to select option number three as the correct one, which is the odd man out related to need of multilingualism. Okay, these two questions, they are related to multilingualism. Okay, so let's see the questions. Question number 16, learning of second language does not interfere with first language is called as dash dash type of multilingualism. And the options are additive, the second is subtractive, third is divisional, and fourth is none of the above. Now, which is the correct option? If we see the types of multilingualism, basically there are two types of multilingualism, and the divisional, it is not a type of multilingualism. So automatically we are going to eliminate option number three. And now what are options left with us, we are going to find out the correct one. So additive, subtractive, and none of the above. So let's think about the first two options, that is additive and subtractive. If we see definition, in that definition, so learning of second language does not interfere with first language, it's called as, and the option is additive type of multilingualism. So here I'm going to log option number one as a correct option. So let's move towards the next question. Question number 17. Learning of second language does interfere with first language. It's called as. You can see the difference between the previous question and this question. In the first question, means the question number 16, there was learning of second language does not interfere. And in this question, does interfere. Okay. So the question is, learning of second language does interfere with first language is called as dash dash type of multilingualism. And I think easily you can find the answer of these questions because already we saw what is additive. Okay. And there is no type of multilingualism that is divisional. It is not a type of multilingualism. So we are going to eliminate option number 1 and 3. And only two options left with us, that is option number 2 and 4. And if we see the definition of subtractive, it is given there, that is learning of second language does interfere with first language is called as subtractive type of multilingualism. So here I'm going to lock option number 2, that is the correct one. Yes, now see from where I took the entire material, and for this I used different learning material from the websites only. So now I'm going to share the link of the learning material related to 202 in the description box. So after clicking on those links, easily you will access the learning material. And now this is the time to say thanks to you. Thank you, my dear ones. Have a nice day. Take care. Bye-bye.